Have you ever wondered why the planets in the solar system have such weird and bizarre names? In this video, I will be explaining how and why each of the eight planets got their names. All the planets, but Earth and Uranus, were named after Roman gods. Uranus was named after a Greek god, and Earth is its own peculiarity. The Greek and Roman civilizations saw the planets as godlike creations, and decided to name them in their honor. But how did they decide which god to choose? Well, the ancient Romans and Greeks noticed that each planet had specific characteristics that made them unique. They correlated these characteristics and chose the god that best represented them. This naming method was used for pretty much all the planets in the solar system. Now, let's start with the first planet in the solar system, Mercury. Mercury is a small scorched world with barely any atmosphere and a heavily cratered surface. Given its proximity to the sun, Mercury's year is just 88 days long. The ancient Romans noticed this, and hence named the planet after the god of messenger and travelers, Mercury. Venus is named after the Roman goddess of beauty, and it's not hard to see why. Venus has a thick atmosphere, 90 times more dense than Earth's. Because of this, almost all sunlight is reflected off the clouds of Venus and back into space. The planet is the brightest object in the sky besides the moon and the sun, and it was named after the goddess because of this characteristic. Next, we get to Earth, our home planet. It is the only planet not named after a Greek or Roman god. Instead, it is derived from the Anglo-Saxon word Erda. But why is Earth not named after a god like the other planets? Well, the Romans didn't think of Earth as a planet at the time. They thought of it more as an entity, in the center of the universe where everything revolved around us. Once science proved that Earth was a planet many centuries later, the name had already been solidified. A similar thing happened to the moon. Mars is the fourth planet in the solar system, and was named after the Roman god of war. This was due to the reddish pigmentation on the surface, signifying blood and battle to the early Roman observers. Another interesting fact about Mars is the naming of its moons, Phobos and Deimos. They were discovered much later in 1877, and were named after Ares' children, the Greek equivalent of Mars. You could say that Mars and its moons were technically father and sons. Jupiter is the biggest planet in the solar system, and has a diameter of 140,000 kilometers across. It is so big that you could fit 1,300 Earths inside of it. It was rightly named after the king of the gods, Jupiter, by the Romans. The four largest moons of Jupiter, also known as the Galilean moons, are known as Io, Ganymede, Callisto, and Europa. These names came from the many lovers of Jupiter, so the planet and its moons are in a kind of love-hate relationship, at least in a mythological sense. Saturn is known for its iconic rings, which stretch over 282,000 kilometers across. That's 22 Earths placed side by side. Saturn is named after the god for wealth and liberation. His Greek equivalent is Kronos, so he's more of a titan than a god. Saturn's moons follow suit, with names such as Iapetus, Dione, and Tethys, all of which are Titans. Even the biggest moon of Saturn is called Titan. Moving on, Uranus is the only planet named after a Greek god. It was the first planet discovered using telescope rather than the naked eye in 1781. Uranus actually had a different name for 70 years, devised by its discoverer William Herschel. He named it the Georgium Sidus in honor of King George III, which, in my opinion, is a horrendous name for a planet. Fortunately, an astronomer named Johann Bode came to the rescue, suggesting the name Uranus after the Greek god of the sky and heavens, and the name stuck. As for its moons, their names came from the characters in the works of William Shakespeare and Alexander Pope, such as Puck, Ariel, and Oberon. And finally, Neptune was the only planet in the solar system predicted to exist using mathematics. It was done so using Uranus, which seemed to be pulled off its normal orbit, signifying an eighth planet. Its name is derived from the Roman god of the sea because of its strong bluish hue. In a similar way, the planet's moons were named after minor sea gods, such as Triton, the biggest moon of Neptune and messenger of the sea in Roman mythology. And they were the name origins of all the planets and moons in the solar system. If you enjoyed the video, consider subscribing for weekly videos on astronomy and the universe. Until next time, goodbye.